welcome to the Drive By Reviews, where today is an exciting day because I have just picked up a Sony A7 III, one of the most hyped full-frame cameras out on the market today, and it just recently came out. I'm pretty stoked about this because it's going to be a welcome upgrade to the gear that I've been using to produce content on the channel. Now, without further ado, let's get this puppy open and take a look and see what's inside, as well as the photo and videos this puppy produces in real-world use. Check it out. All right, here we go. Got the Sony A7 III. And I'm gonna unbox this puppy. You got a picture of the camera on the front and a little bit of information about it on the side. On the back, you got everything listed on the basic specs of this camera as far as it being a full frame 35 millimeter, 24.2 megapixels. You got your ISO range, its massive speed, 10 frames per second. The massive autofocus point, 693, we'll take a look at that. This is new for the A7 series with the 3, it's the eye autofocus. Silent shooting, 5-axis steady shot, dual slots for the cards, and more. And we're gonna check all that out when I do the full review of this camera. But let's pop it open and see how it's laid out inside. Okay, what do we got here? We got our registration, limited warranty, bunch of information in different languages. Probably a good idea to go through that, and I'll do that later. But let's take a look at the camera itself. Nice, we get a Sony strap with A7 marked on it. Oh, here we go, here's the lens that comes with this particular package. I decided to go with the lens combo because you save a little bit. It's got a nice lens hood there. Was that why was that off of it? Oh, plastic hood cover. Honestly, I don't know, I've kind of grown accustomed to seeing metal on more expensive lenses, but here we have the 28-70 lens. Nice, and that zoom has some pretty nice and crisp feel to it. It's got a stiff movement as well, so that'd be nice to use. And I always like to make sure that everything is nice and purdy when it's brand new. And I believe this is the camera itself. Not sure how it's supposed to open. Oh, there we go. I like how space bags is the way you are supposed to box cameras for some reason, these weird space bags. And there it is. From what I understand, the body is almost identical to the A7 R3, besides some, you know, upgrades that they had to leave in the more expensive camera. But overall, the weight and everything is pretty similar. And of course, you've got the different buttons that have been changed quite a bit. And we'll go a little bit into detail on that in this video. What I'm really excited about is this dual card slot that you have on the side here, which is just something that I was really disappointed in some of the other options out there with similarly spec'd cameras from other companies. So I'm excited to see that here in this camera that's less than $2,000. Now, coming from the A6000, this is quite an upgrade for me, and I can already kind of see the weight and feel this camera is much heavier. And it'll be interesting to see how this works with my gimbal. And there you have the sensor, the battery, I have no idea. Down here, I'm guessing is, okay, charge, adapter. Okay, USB cable. And I believe this is, yeah, the battery, the Z series battery for twice the capacity from the previous model, the Mark II. And that is phenomenal. Just for comparison's sakes, you can see the two batteries. Here's the Z series battery. And the previous battery, with the 2x capacity, of course, it's a little bit larger, but that's a small price to pay for the amount of time you're gonna be able to spend without worrying about swapping out the battery, especially for those of you who use the Sony cameras for a lot of video projects. That's gonna be a huge deal. And of course, you can take, from what I hear, thousands of photos on one battery. So that's pretty exciting right there. All right, let's take a closer look at the Sony A7 III, which one of the great things about this camera is that aesthetically and operationally overall, it's almost identical to the R3. There's some small differences like the locking mechanism on the mode dial and some ports that aren't on the A7 III. But let's see what we do have. Over here on the left side of the camera, we have a headphone port, an HDMI port, you have a microphone jack, and you have a type C USB port. And then of course you've got your micro USB port with the charge lamp, and you know, you can use that port to charge the camera directly, download pictures directly, and all that good stuff. Now, on the other side, that's where your dual card slot sits, and you've got slot 1 and 2, where slot 1 is the faster slot that allows for the, you know, type 2 cards that go extremely fast. In fact, what I'm gonna be utilizing for 4K capture
is the Extreme Pro series from SanDisk that has up to 300 megabytes per second. But you know, technically, unless you're going to be shooting the 100 megabytes per second mode that's in the camera for video, you probably don't need something quite as fast as that. Probably 90 megabytes per second is all you need. And as you can see back here, we've got some difference in upgrades in the buttons themselves, as we got larger wheels, larger dials, and a couple add-ons here. And a lot of custom buttons in very nice spots, including a change of the record button, which is moved from over on the side, a very awkward spot that we all know, to right here, bottom right of the EV. And of course, another custom button on the left, and your menu button up here. Now this is touchscreen, but on default it is deactivated, and depending if you like that, you can turn it back on. Really, I think one of the best uses for the touchscreen is probably if you're gonna view your photos and you wanna zoom in and move it around with the actual touchscreen as opposed to using the little joystick dial up here on the left. But that's just personal preference right there, and it's nice to have that capability of touchscreen if you want it. Now I will say this, going from the A6000 to a full frame option like the Sony A7III, this is quite a bit heavier. It almost feels two times heavier, and I'll actually take a look at the exact weight. And I'm curious how it'll operate with my gimbal, because as we all know, the heavier your camera gets and your lens gets, the more difficult the, you know, the motors in the gimbal have with keeping you steady and not having faults throw. So we'll see if that works out with smooth footage. The nice thing about this is with its optical stable shot internally and of course in the lens itself, it's a very smooth camera even without a gimbal. But there is always a huge difference when you have something that stabilizes outside the camera as well. Now I'll also say, as I've always said about Sony cameras, and this is actually a personal preference because I've heard negatives and positives, but I do like the ergonomics of the camera. I like how it holds in my hand as far as the size. Even with the extra weight compared to the A6000, it's a very nice feel. It's a little bulkier, of course, than those smaller camera options. Bulkier than the A6500, 6300. But I like that bulk, and it's just kind of a matter of how are you storing your camera, how are you taking this along. This is definitely not a camera you can just stick in your pocket. However, it is a camera that is going to have quite a bit more capabilities than the 6500, so it really depends on what you need. Although I would say if the 6500 does everything you want and you don't need the full frame capabilities that the A7III gives, you know, you might need to go to a store and hold each one and see if it's going to be portable for you compared to your current option. All right, without further ado, let's take some quick shots and video and see how this camera performs in the real world. You guys go a quick look at the Sony A7III, and I'll say this, so far it's exceeded my expectations, but I'll save all my big huge thoughts about this camera for the full review that I'll put out shortly. I'm really excited to do a lot of the testing, by the way, especially with the video testing, low light testing and all that, so stay tuned for those videos. And if you have a special request or test you'd like me to try out on the camera, let me know, but I'll probably end up covering it anyways at some point because I do love going through all the details of tech. All right guys, thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time on Drive-By Reviews.